broadcast live.
On Goonie Landing. Which is interesting, you know, for me. I was like, so, because I thought you'd be from Cape Town. Someone said, no, you're from Durban. But I was like, yo, how deeply rooted are you in your Durban grassroots space, you know, as in like, there was another picture I saw you, it was a random picture where you were dressed like a spaceman, but there was a cow next to you, you know?
Yeah.
I was trying to understand, like, Ganti, Sigupi, you know, is it like, you know, like, you know, the Milky Lane with the cow jumping?
Yeah. So that thing, like, actually, that whole concept, whether it's Afrovision, I did one similar called Zulu Skywalker. Yeah. I am a conspiracy theorist, right?
Yeah.
I'm a nerd, right?
Yeah.
So I like.
Oh my gosh.
I like the things about like Africans being in space.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
I like that idea, whether it was through them being like in a trance or through Bungoma or like being there.
Yeah.
So I like playing with those ideas, you know, because I feel like, you know, like when you watch a Kung Fu movie and it convinces you that if you learn Kung Fu, you can fly.
Yeah.
You watch a Harry Potter movie and it convinces you that if you're in London or whatever, that those guys have magic or whatever.
Yeah,
there's witches and wizards.
Yeah.
We don't have that here.
Yeah,
here, it's seen like Gloria, Tsaga. You know what I mean?
So
you're in Africa, Zoloyo. You know what I mean? But in there, it's like, oh, like.
They make Ugloya to be beautiful.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? It's like, Harry Potter, manga Gloria. You wanna be lawyered by Harry Potter,
you know what I mean? So it's like one of those things. So I like that idea of just taking some of those stories that we grew up with and just flipping them.
So the whole
thing of like, being in space, but kinda like cows around me. It's like, okay, cool, we Africans, but we're in space.
The whole thing
of like Zulu Skywalker, you know what I mean? It has a thing of like, you know, you in space, whatever. So I like playing around with those ideas.
So Nas is like Nasu.
So Nasu.
Nazo,
Imuni, Imuni. You know, it's crazy to me. Like, why is like Inyanga someone that is healing, but also it's the moon? Like, just like where how language, like, you know, maybe the secrets of our sort of culture as like Africans is in the language.
Yeah,
I just like exploring that.
And I mean, that for me, that also kind of connects to the King Shaka Symphony. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Where it kind of. You know, I always go, what is actually really underestimated about Shaka Zulu is, besides the fact that he was a great warrior, is that he drove a lot of innovation.
You know,
I was telling someone, I was saying, on Game of Thrones, there's a scene where they fight and they attack a certain way, which is taken from Shaka's move, you know? Something as Shaka had a knife where, like, or a spear where, like every spear was just a spear, and he created a handle.
Yeah.
So when I stab you, I
can pull it out. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Leave it. Yeah. So now it's a proper weapon. In Ikwa. Yeah, Ikwa. Yeah, I think of that. I don't know.
Yeah, you know. So you think about all those things and you go, the level of innovation.
Yeah.
And but how it's not but the one side is only celebrated.
Yeah.
Because it's almost like even the microphone. I forgot what they call it, Iwisa or whatever. There's this Zulu thing where you hold, and when you're holding it, you're the only one that can speak.
Speak, yeah.
I think is it Uisa?
Uisa, Sakila, I don't know. I can't.
It's
but it has the thing. Like,
it has the
designs.
Like things like that, where like that thing is like actually,
yeah.
The mic is shaped like that.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. I never even saw it like that. That's fucking true.
No, but the mic is shaped because, and it talks to, when this guy is holding it, this is the only guy that can speak.
Yeah, microphone. That's crazy. Wow. I need to name a song, Microphone. That's so cool. I like shit like that. Like, I like finding the thread between ancient Egyptians and Khoisan.
Yeah, I like finding that thread, bro.
Like, because I feel like no one's gonna tell us, right? So I like that whole. I like understanding why. Why did Africans start writing like things on walls? Why did we stop? Why did we take our words and put them in folklore?
Yeah.
And why did we take our secrets and put them in language? That's my shit.
But things as simple as a crowd, like you know when you watch it in all these fighting movies from the world, those white people with swords.
Yeah.
Like when you go to wherever there's always like a person, a guard that's watching from the top, someone that's coming.
Yeah.
And like and that thing is something that like Zulus were already doing.
Yeah.
So even the circle that is literally built where like, you know, the kitchen is here, and if you've got three wives, different wives can only get into the kitchen.
Yeah.
They can't share the space in the kitchen. Monday, there's Monday wife in the kitchen, Tuesday wife.
Yeah.
And then you literally like have a whole thing that in the center at the top, that's where the mother stays or whatever the case be. Or it's all these things literally are, it's architecture.
It is like warmer sort of like crowds, and like I feel like also if you look at even like other tribes, like that knowledge was being shared, but we just don't know, right? So now we just have all these like, oh, you Zulu, you Tswana, we can't see the common thread.
Exactly.
It's so cool. They just found out, I think like a few years ago, like even igloos in Alaska and stuff, like the reason why they like that is because it keeps heat.
So
a hut is always cool.
Yeah, hut is always cool.
Always cool. You know what I mean? Hot day, cold day. So it's like all of those things, like all of that like information, how did they know? You know? So it's I don't know.
It goes as far as, you know, inside the crowd, you know, they always have the kettle.
Listen.
Inside the crowd, they had kettle, right?
Dude.
And inside the cat, and what they had, they always had like, you know, when you watch movies like during a war, and they've always got food like hidden under a basement.
Yeah.
So what they did is that if you had to attack us, and you literally had to take the cattle, everything else, and like kill our army or whatever the case be, they literally inside the fridge. There's a hole where they've thrown all the food.
Yeah.
So when if there's nothing, you've taken all the food, at least we can go back and dig the hole. Even like say things like having like that safe hold where like, yo, food is stocked here.
That's crazy.
Whenever, you know what I mean?
That's
I can go as far as like,
we need to joke.
I'm saying, I can go as far as like, even how girls got proposed and how girls were rejecting with like.
Yeah, it's crazy, man.
Yo, man. Now, I took a visit recently and took my kids there. I was like, yo, let's go get school.
Check this shit out.
You know what I mean? You know? Yeah. Damn, man. I mean, you've just mentioned also like obviously sunshine.
Cannot lie, don't feel like me today. You might be okay in the summertime. I'm hoping the sunshine will open. Oh my blessings, don't go away. I'm hoping the sunshine will open.
It's like we could have a nerd talk forever, bro.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Cool. I love that.
With everything though, like, I mean, I think that you're just reliving. I always go like, it's like you're almost reliving something that was suppressed in someone else's life. Whenever it blows. So if someone wanted to sing or was connected to music, but something in circumstance never allowed it, we are kind of relive that. Yeah. What do you wanna? Besides leaving the legacy for Zeno, and what does Zeno mean by the
Zenobos?
You just made it a space name.
Yeah, Zeno.
Because you knew that if you came with your parents and you said Zeno Galaxy, but what is it in the end? You know what do you want to see in the world? Because I'm not even looking at you like it's the music. It's like, what do you want to see in the world? You know what I mean?
Yeah. I think, man, like, I I know I'm in a loophole.
Yeah.
I know I'm like in Africa, I'm a one in a million.
Yeah.
And that's the problem.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. The problem is that like I've had to, like I come from a very like poor background and I've been lucky, right? And I've met people and I've had an attitude of teachability, and that's how I'm here. And I know that I still need to go forward and learn more. But like how many guys in the township do I know that are talented, dog? And they're just like there. Because to them, there's a gate at the end of the township. To them, mentally, you know what I mean? So it's almost like a mental sort of breakdown of that has been ingrained in us because of like I can't say that word. It's too many. There's too many. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, yeah.
Because of that,
you've been colonized.
Colonized.
Colonization.
Yes, there it is. Because of that, because of apartheid, because of all of that, being beaten down for so long that now you don't even believe in yourself. Right? And you're free, but mentally, like, we're still, like, ingrained in it, because there's still a lot of people that think good to success is the proximity to whiteness, right? And it's like, if that can, so there's still a lot of unlearning that needs to happen before we can even see people that are truly proud of themselves. If I'm proud of being Zulu, it doesn't mean that I think someone else is less than that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm just proud of that, you know? And it's like, to be able to see more of that, then we start seeing more of Africa being exported instead of exploited, you know what I mean? Because like people come here because they know we the shit, you know, they come here and they take, you know, and because we don't know what we have, we let them take, right? And then it's like, it needs to get to a point where it's like, nah, fuck you, you know what I mean? Fuck you, like we need to...
Not even fuck you, hear our terms.
Like, yeah, this is, and to a point even where people that are in like higher places think like the people at the lower places, because that's what we have right now, is a disconnect. A person gets into a place of power and then they want to retain that place of power for them, and then you forget where you came from, and then it keeps happening.
So let me ask you a question.
So,
man.
Yeah.
Let me ask you a question. And that's why I asked you, you know, I can ask you about music, but just through our conversation, you're a nerd like me. Yeah, I just said that in another interview. Yeah. I said I'm a nerd. Yeah, you know. How many of us, though, you know, it's how many of us admit that we've come out of a gate and we won in a million.
Yeah.
And if all of us that admit that we've come out of a gate can say, hey, you came out the gate, I came out the gate, so-and-so came out the gate, how about we collaborate?
Yeah. Because that rhymed. That's so cool.
I know, I was trying to say something else, but I was like, yeah. I was just like, you know. It's just like all the people who are out the gate need to collaborate.
Yeah.
You know, you see it with what's happening with Music is King. You see it with different, but even those, like all of us that are getting out the gate are collaborating in isolation though.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, imagine the power of us. And it could be 30, 40, the power of all of us who just came out the gate.
Yeah.
Who went back and said, this is how we could resolve it in this side of the world, that side of the world. Because the truth of the matter is that my theory is that even if you are sitting in an office somewhere and you're not a musician and you just have a job, a good job, and you're black, you have broken out the gate.
You're in a loophole. Yep.
Because you know where you come from, the millions that haven't.
Yeah.
So if all of us who got out the gate had to kind of come together.
Yeah. Black people need to start having meetings, man. But like, I think also like the first like...
Not meetings to meet.
Yeah, not to like actually like talk about it. Like I think...
But the thing is that when black people come, when they come out these gates, they literally want to come out and say, I came out so hard and I did so well out the gate. Instead of being equals. So then we start canceling each other on how well out of the gate I am
in this big bad game of white monopoly.
Exactly.
So it's like, I think, man, at the end of the day, it's like, okay, also because people are different, some people don't want to do that. You know, some people are like, Mina, I made it, I'm cool, I'm good, right? But the biggest problem like that I've seen is like when you say like collaborate, right? The most important part of that collaboration is the sharing of knowledge.
I ain't saying physically, it's sharing no, of because, knowledge.
Because I think sometimes, like, when we, like, I know you know what you mean when you say that.
Yeah.
But, like, I think sometimes when people think of how we can get up, they think of money.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah,
and
yeah.
they think, and it's like, dude, like, if I can give you a million, but if you don't know what to do with that million, it's like, I'm wasting it. Right? So it's like, the problem is education. Whether that's education about how do you make music and sell it or put it on Spotify?
Yeah.
How does Spotify pay back?
Thank you.
Like all these things, you. There's no Thank you. Education. Thank you. Thank that's you. Why I don't know how many guys you met. Dude, I want to be famous. How do I get on shows?
Exactly. Guys don't want to understand the education behind
there's
it.
Education.
And when you start giving them the education, you're boring.
Exactly. Exactly. No one wants to listen. Because then it's like the education almost comes across as you're sunning them.
Yeah, yeah.
It's like, oh no, here, okay, I'm helping you. This is what you need to do. And it's like, you helping me? I don't need your help. And you're like, huh?
It comes to a point where, like, you know, I've got a disclaimer. Like, even as a OG, it's like, when I say something, I'm always like, it's just my view.
Yeah.
You don't have to do it this way.
Yeah.
And then I use examples of people who never took my advice.
Yeah.
And still did well.
Yeah.
Because I don't want you to feel that, oh, the OG said, and you know, he trying to, so I'm
he
trying to show,
key,
yeah, he gave, I'm just saying, yo, sometimes, but some part of this collaboration is just picking up a phone and saying, yo, Muzi.
Yeah.
Yo, that shit was dope.
That's cool. Yeah. Like, yeah. Like, dude, like what you do, I actually called FKA, man, she dropped an EP on Friday. Yeah. I'm like, dude, I'm just calling you to say that your EP is fire.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that could go like so far. For some, because we don't even like try to like pick each other up, or I can't say you have a nice picture because you're taking my followers.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's like we're probably finishing. Oh, if this was tape, it would be finished. But
it was VHS. but it's a real thing, man. You know, I mean, this is dope, man. We can go on and on, but I think a huge part of this thing here is literally. To shout out cats.
Yeah, bro. Like
you know what I mean?
Like what you're doing, dog, is so important. Like, because it's giving a voice, right? You had a voice and then you chose to like give us like the megaphone.
And then I cancelled
myself. And then you cancelled yourself on Twitter. Like, Slikour, like, who the fuck is Slikour online? Where did Slikour go? You know what I mean? But like that whole thing is it's important, man. And obviously not everyone can do it, we understand that.
But everyone can do it in their own
variations.
In their
own way. Exactly. You know what I mean? Like, and then together it sort of becomes this big thing of helping, of knowledge, of sharing knowledge. Mm. You know what I mean? Of us doing that and having even a chance to have an alternative voice.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because as much as it started off as a hip hop thing, it's not that anymore. Mm. It's bigger than that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you're doing great, man. I'm proud of you, bro. I'm sorry you cancelled yourself on social media.
Not a lot of people saw me cancel myself. So when anyone goes, yo, you were on Slick, and then you became Slick online, then I know that you know what's up. Yeah. You know what's up. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
yo, man, thanks, B. I really appreciate this. And I'm glad, you know, it's actually the first time we're meeting.
Yeah, like proper.
Like proper.
It's not just like
classic. Like proper. We've literally had these electronic relationships. And even at an event, you know, I was like, you know, when someone goes, that's Muzi playing. But I'm always seeing you from there. And I'm like, I don't really know what it looks like. Yeah, like, you know, like in real life. But like, fucking, you're a dope dude, man. You know what I mean? You're a dope dude. And I wish you all the luck. And most importantly, just... the energy that you have, man, I just wish that like you, it kind of like simmers down to another generation of yours and a generation that follows.
Yeah.
That also has the energy to pull people, to get people excited.
Yeah.
Because the only way we win, I'd say people, there's no success without being a nerd.
Yeah, you have to learn and you have to read, and then like I want someone to stand on my shoulders.
Yeah.
I want to be like a guy like in my 50s or whatever and having someone do what I did better than me. I want that to happen because it's like it's the only way, dog. I wanna be able to pass on the baton and be like, yo, dude, listen, this is my blueprint.
Yeah.
Take this to the next level, or even better, yo, if it's a woman, be 30 times better because dudes are just like full of ego. Yeah. Anyways, take this and push it, you know? Yeah. Like, this is what I did and this is how, like, I got to where I got. But, like, you can take it and put it into the next. I want to be that guy because I feel like, the reason why I feel like it keeps on stagnating, it grows, and then it stagnates, is because we don't even, like, South Africa is still at a place where our legends can't even be celebrated properly. You know what I mean? Like, we don't have, like, a Keith Richards, besides maybe, like, a Babu Himasegela, where he was, like, still celebrated being an OG and he was old, you know what I mean?
It's international PR also.
Also, because, yeah. But now, why did he have, like, he had to leave. We all have to leave.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's,
yeah.
like...
You had to leave for you to come get interviewed. Yeah.
like, everyone has to coffee. Yeah, everyone, yeah, yeah. It's like, it's a Trevor Noah. It's like, it's a beautiful thing that people can go in and spread the South African word to, like, the world. But it's kind of like, to win.
Yeah, yeah.
So we have to, like, learn how to take care of our own and then have the OGs not feel, like, ostracized.
You
know what I mean? It's like, no, dog.
We got to literally look at it as a whole culture.
It's a whole culture.
It's a whole culture. You got to look at it as it's a household.
Yeah.
We've got parents to guide us. We got the oldest brother, teenage sister, the little. We got to look at it as a household.
Yeah.
But only the guys who come out the gate have to do. But it's the guys who come out the gate also who don't think inside the gate. You know.
Yeah. But it, like, becomes a young man's game until you're old, and then you're like, you're trying to stop what you're perpetrating for, like, the longest time, then it becomes a problem.
But what you need to always remember is that Henry Ford, there's no way he could have made a car if he wasn't a nerd.
Yeah.
Leonardo da Vinci, there's no way he could have painted all that shit if he wasn't a nerd.
He didn't spend the time.
Prince could have no way been who he is if he wasn't a nerd.
If he wasn't learning how to play all those instruments.
Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
And it's not even about what you learn to play, but it's once you're able to take what you've learned and transfer that to an emotion and a feeling.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
People feel, I feel this about it.
Yeah.
Now, there's no way, the thing is that we shy away from us being nerds, which means that we shy away from our blessings.
Yeah, true.
Because the only way you focus on your blessing is if you're nerdy about it.
Yep.
And if you can literally, like, be nerdy about your blessing, you are able to create a feeling. And if you shy away from being the nerd, if you shy away from saying, I can't do this because this is really what I want to do, which is create.
Yeah.
You know, I know it comes with the money, it comes with the lights, it comes with the whatever.
Yeah.
But actually, I just need to step back.
Yeah.
So sometimes we literally get caught up in the product of what being nerdy creates.
The results,
And we get so locked in the product that we push away being the nerd. I don't want to make music.
Yeah.
Oh man, this music shit. It just, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's too much, bro.
We become bigger than our blessing.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah,
and we just hang in the sky.
And then you end up standing for nothing. And also because you shout,
and you're mad at everybody.
You become bitter.
Yeah.
There's no other choice because you can't really face yourself and that you've put yourself in that situation and that you didn't appreciate the things that you had when you had them and you didn't realize that it's people that got you where you are. As much as your art is important and everything, like, every art industry is about two things, the art and the relationships you build with the art, right? And you need to nurture both of those things, and it's like it's pretty much like humanity, right? And then, like, but if you forget about those things, or if most importantly you think that you've arrived, you just left, because that means you can't learn anything from anyone because you're an usui boss, and then I think, like, and you see it happen in different ways over and over again. Personally, I do not want to be that guy. If there's always a chance for me to learn and I'm always willing to learn, you know, and then, like, that's how I want to, like, go with my career. I'm always willing to learn. Like, there's always someone that has information that I might need to make me a better person.
Yo, and on that note, shout out Zeno. Is available on all streams.
Zeno's out now.
You know, make sure you check out Muzi on the set. You know, if he's done his set, if he's done his performance set, he's probably gonna play you some shit. This guy literally, like, just doesn't stop. You're like, you had a show, like, Kanduzo Tetani.
I'm great.
Yo, shout out, man. Thanks for coming through.
Thank you so much for having me, bro.
Yes, man.
Thank you,
easy.
Yeah, bro. Broadcast live.